Adamu Emeka Tosin. You just heard about land banking. That is sweet, oh, and they're making huge return on investment. You're running to go and invest. Calm down. Before you go and invest, have you vetted that company? Have you checked the company? Does it have a good track record? And is there any insurance policies that will take care of your money in case, let's say for instance, that company fold up or anything happens to that company? Is your money insured? You're thinking about it, Abby? Think about it, though, because it's very important. Not all land bankings are what it seems, though. Hello and welcome to Educate with Maki Sparks. I am Amaka Okusasere. So for those who don't know what land banking is a process of acquiring property now at a lower price to sell in the future. So you buy those properties now, be it land or houses, because properties here in Nigeria and around the world tend to appreciate. So real estate has a very good margin of attraction in terms of wealth creation. So land banking has semi forms in the sense that you can do for 3 months, you can do for 6 months, and you can do for 1 year. So most real estate company, what they do is that they buy these properties or houses or land at a much cheaper price right now, then sell in the next 3-6 months, and they make high return on investment. So it's the return on investment they make from buying this land at a much cheaper rate. Then they sell later in 2-3 months when it has made huge return on investment, and they will now sell off. So it's from that money that they make as the return on investment that they're able to pay those interest rates. Like for 3 months, they have 15%. For 6 months, some companies pay 20%. Then some for 1 year, they pay 22 to 25 thereabout. And you remember I said that if you're going into land bank, you have to ascertain your risk capacity, in the sense that you have to know if that company has like an insurance policy that will be in place in case there's anything that goes wrong in your investment, so you don't just lose out on everything. The company you are investing or doing that land banking with, what is their track record? How many years have they done this land banking? How many years have they been in business to do the land banking? Then another thing you should also look out for is their interest at heart. What are they investing this money into? Some real estate companies have an existing project already on ground, like housing projects. So when you land bank into their own company, they use this money to fund the building projects, of which after like 2 to 3 months, when they are done and they put in the right facilities and facade inside, they tend to sell at higher price. That's the way they pay you. But in all, do your due diligence and make sure that whoever you're doing land banking with are companies that are reputable, that even stayed like, okay, at most 5 to a decade. And make sure that you have probably like family and friends or people that can ascertain that they've gotten their money. Then if you also want to know more about land banking, we're here to help you out. So you can drop your comments on the comment section. Hope this was insightful and you learned one or two. So this is basically everything that has to do with land banking. Don't forget to also like, subscribe, and also share. So see you on the next one.